everyone. In this video, we are going to explain Raman effect. Actually, this question is important from the examination point of view for degree 3 students. Sorry, degree 2 students, paper 4B. So, in this video, in the first part, we will discuss Raman effect. After that, its quantum theory of Raman effect. And next part will be experimental arrangement and its applications. And then last part will be Raman versus infrared spectra. Actually, this is the tail part, which is asked with this question. So this is your tail part. So let us see from initial part. What is Raman effect? Raman, from his experiment, found that when a beam of light is passed through a transparent material, maybe solid, liquid, or gas, it is seen that a part of light is scattered and we get a spectrum. When a spectrum is observed, it is found that few lines have the wavelength as the original light, means there is no change in frequency, or you may say wavelength. But other things we also observe, that we get either longer as well as shorter than the original light. These are Raman lines. Okay, so the lines whose wavelength is same as the original light called Rayleigh scattering, and the lines whose wavelength is either longer or shorter is called Raman lines. And the phenomenon of the change in wavelength of line on passing through the transparent material is known as Raman effect, on the name of its discoverer, C.V. Raman. We all are familiar with the scientist C.V. Raman, which India celebrate National Science Day on 28 February each year. So you can understand the importance of this. Raman lines of larger wavelength or a smaller frequency, see here. You know that a wavelength and frequency is inversely proportional. That is why I have written here, larger wavelength means a smaller frequency, known as Stokes lines. While those with shorter wavelength or larger frequency, known as anti-Stokes lines. Okay. The frequency difference between a Raman line and the original line depends on the substance used as a scatterer. Thus, Raman shifts are the characteristics of a scattering substance. From figure, you can see this is the Rayleigh line, which frequency is same to the original line. But here right side is Stokes line, left side anti-Stokes lines. Okay. Now we are going to give a quantum theory. Means we are going to explain the Raman effect. We will explain on the basis of quantum theory. As you know from the quantum theory, a wave of frequency nu consists of photons. In general, we say that light is made of photons, and each photon has energy h nu. What is h? Planck's constant. What is nu? Frequency. When light is incident on the scatterer, means if light falls on the substance, the photon collide with the molecules of the substance. Here collision may be elastic or inelastic. So let us consider elastic collision. Means if the collision is elastic, there is no transfer of energy from photon to the molecule and vice versa. The photon is therefore scattered without loss or gain of energy. Okay, because here neither molecule receives energy nor loss energy. Since collision is elastic, so there is no transfer of energy. In this case, the frequency of the scattered photon is the same as that of frequency of the incident light. This explains the presence of Rayleigh lines. As I told you earlier, if there is no change, it is Rayleigh line in the scattered light of Raman spectrum. But if we see the another possibility in which there is a loss or gain of energy, then what happens? Suppose the incident photon of energy h nu collides with a molecule having kinetic energy half mv square and internal energy ei. After collision, you know that after collision, if there is exchange of energy, velocity will change, frequency will change. So that I have written here, let nu 1 be the frequency of the scattered photon. It was assumed earlier nu, but here I have assumed nu 1, and v 1 the velocity of the molecule. Automatically the kinetic energy will be half mv on square. Initially its kinetic energy was half mv square, and now after collision it is half mv 1 square. Here ei is the internal energy before collision, EF is the internal energy after collision. And see here, third term, H nu is the energy of the photon before collision, but after collision it is H nu. Since there is no change in temperature during the collision, if collision takes place and temperature does not change, it means kinetic energy will not change. And that is why half mv square must be equal to half mv 1 square, so they cancel out. Now the terms left are ei plus h nu is equal to ef plus h nu. On solving, you will get nu is equal to nu 1 plus del e by h. What is del e here? Del e is the difference of internal energy, ef minus ei. Here there are two possibilities, depending upon whether photon loses energy to molecule or molecule loses energy to photon. Suppose the molecule gains energy, means when photon incident upon the substance, molecules gains energy from the photon and goes from a lower energy level to higher energy level. So, naturally, when molecule will receive energy, will gain energy, it will come in excited state and it will go from lower energy level to higher energy level. Here lower energy level stands E1 and E2 stands for higher energy level, so that E2 minus E1 is positive because it goes to higher energy level after gaining energy, and hence nu 1 is equal to nu minus del. So here I come to here nu 1, this nu 1 is equal to nu minus del E by H. You can see the frequency of the scattered photon is less than that of incident photon due to this minus sign. This explains the presence of modified Stokes lines. Second possibility, when molecule, suppose molecule already in the excited state, and when photon incident, it will not gain energy, instead it will lose energy. So it may lose energy to the photon, which may have frequency nu 2. And on the basis of above calculation, similar to above expression, we can write nu 2 is equal to nu plus del E by H. Here plus, it means frequency of the scattered photon is higher than that of incident photon. Okay, this explains the anti-Stokes lines on the higher frequency or shorter wavelength side of the Raman spectrum. Okay, I hope you have understood. Now we focus on the experimental arrangement. So see here, experimental arrangement. The apparatus used to study Raman effect in liquid, it's shown in figure. You will see figure. It was originally developed by Wood. It consists of a glass tube containing experimental liquid free from dust and air bubbles. See here, dust and air bubbles. Free from dust and air means transparent liquid. One end of the tube is closed with by optically plain glass plate. We come to the figure. See here, this is tube AB. Its one end is covered with glass window. This acts as a window, and this is reflector R. You can see here R. R is the reflector. Actually, it is it reflects the light, and this is discharge tube S. Okay, and see here, other end of the tube is drawn like horn shape. Okay, H, and the tube is surrounded by jacket. This one J, you can see here J, jacket through which cold water is circulating. So if there is any heat due to spark or due to this discharge tube, so it saves us from overheating. Actually, it acts as cooling agent. Because here water is circulating from here. You can see from water is circulating, and this is an exit part. Okay. And this is a slit, and this is a lens. This one is lens. And as I told you, the tube is surrounded by water jacket J, through which cold water is circulated to prevent overheating of the liquid due to proximity of the mercury arc. This is mercury arc. R is a semi-cylindrical polished aluminium reflector used to increase the intensity of the illumination. So its description is here. First, I told you it consists of a glass tube which contains liquid, experimental liquid. One end of the tube is closed with optically glass, plain glass plate, acts as window W. Other end is drawn into the shape of horn shape and blackened on the outside. It is known as Raman tube. Light from a mercury arc source is first passed through a suitable filter. You can see filter. This one is filter. Okay. This one is filter. And R is the reflector, as I already explained you. The scattered light coming out of the window. So when the scattered light comes out through this window, falls on the slit. You can see this is your slit. And passes through a lens. What is the role of lens system? Actually, it converges all the light to the spectrograph. The spectrograph is carefully aligned along the axis of the Raman tube. This is your Raman tube and axis here. Okay, so it is, you can see it is carefully aligned to receive the direct rays of the arc. A short focus camera is used to photograph the spectrum, which consists of a stop line, a few anti-stop line, and a strong unmodified Rayleigh line. So if you observe the spectrum, you will find these things. Now, a part of the question is, what are its applications? There are so many applications. It is not possible to mention all the applications here. Still, I am giving some important applications. Raman effect has been used in the study of structure of molecules. What we do for this? For this purpose, we make an evaluation of wavelength of Raman lines, their intensities and state of polarization. Raman spectra include the vibrational spectrum of the molecules. As you know, the natural frequency of diatomic molecule is nu is equal to V plus half plus, this plus will not be here. By mistake, it has come here. So remove this plus from your note. Okay. And nu 0 is equal to this one here, K by M. K is the spring constant or force constant, you may say. Second use, Raman spectroscopy is commonly used in chemistry. Since vibrational information is specific to the chemical bonds and symmetry of molecules, therefore it provides a fingerprint by which the molecule can be identified. Okay. In solid state physics, a spontaneous Raman spectroscopy is used to characterize materials, measure temperature, and find the crystallographic orientation of a sample. Fourth use, Raman effect has also been applied in the study of some aspects of nuclear physics, such as spin, statistics, and isotopic constituents of the molecules. These are the applications. I have given four applications. In addition to these, there are so many applications. Now, a tail part is asked with this question. Compare Raman effect with infrared spectra. Okay. Raman spectra and infrared spectra appear to same, but there is a difference. See here, first difference. Raman spectra result from scattering of light by vibrating molecules, whereas infrared spectra result from light absorption by vibrating. See here, if in both the cases, vibrating molecules common, but here scattering of light, here absorption. Okay. Second comparison, Raman activity results from change of polarizability of a molecule, whereas infrared activity results from changing dipole moment. So here dipole moment plays an important role. Third, a monochromatic light beam of high intensity laser can be used in UV, visible or infrared regions in Raman measurement, whereas in infrared spectroscopy, the range limited to IR frequencies. There is a limitation here. In case of last, see here. In case of Raman scattered light is observed at right angles to the direction of the incident wave. As I told you in earlier, that we get, when you observe the spectrum, you will get the few lines having original wavelength of the original light, and there are other lines also whose wavelength more than or less than. Okay, so it is seen, it is viewed when you put your eye in normal position. But in case of IR, infrared, the absorption signal is measured in the same direction as the incident. So there is a role of direction here, how to observe. Okay. I hope you have understood this video. Thank you.